For Stephen Bauer, there's no escaping Scarface.
Say hello to my little friend!
And that's just fine with Stephen, whose first ever movie role just happens to be the one he's best known for. As Al Pacino's pal and partner in crime, Manolo, Manny, in Brian De Palma's Miami gangster epic.
Hey, this is my friend Tony Montana I've been telling you about.
30 years after its release, Scarface still carries a lot of weight, with new generations turning Pacino's Tony Montana into a pop culture icon. As for Stephen, well, he knows those streets quite well. His family fled Miami from Cuba after Fidel Castro seized power. And it was there that Stephen was cast in something called Que Pasa USA, the first ever bilingual sitcom on PBS.
Es que nunca la he visto. That's why it's called A Blind Date.
It's about a Cuban exile family in Miami. In all, Stephen's done more than 150 film and TV shows, some very good.
You think there's a difference between a reason and an excuse?
And by the way, in Breaking Bad, Manny gets to be the boss.
Si riegas una gota, te corto la mano.
Others, more your straight to DVD. His latest falls into the first category. It's a series called Ray Donovan. Stars Stephen and Leif Schreiber as a professional troubleshooter who makes the problems go away for the rich and the famous.
You think you're the first person I've dealt with woke up in bed with a dead body?
What a treat this is. Please welcome Stephen Bauer!
Thanks, man.
Good to see you.
You too, how's it going?
Fantastic.
Welcome to the show.
Thank you. Oh, boy. Finally.
It's nice to see you here.
Finally. You're pretty famous.
No.
You're getting there, man.
No.
I hear about you all the time.
Well, I'll tell you, I had one of my sometimes I'll text my friends and say, oh my God, this happened in my life.
Yeah.
One of the times this year that I've only done it a few times in the last X amount of years, but one of the times was I had tweeted, I was watching an episode of Breaking Bad,
uh-huh.
and it was your first episode.
Yes.
And you were on it, and I was like, oh my God, you're on it, right?
Yeah.
And it was, you finally, Manny got to be the boss.
Yeah.
Right?
Yes.
And I tweeted that, and then you retweeted me. And I freaked out.
Yes.
I was like a little girl and Justin Bieber showed out. I freaked out.
That happens to me too. It happens to me too with certain individuals that I've been following. And then when you finally meet them or you finally have contact with them, you're just like, and I get very excited. Yeah.
Well, you're certainly keeping busy. And I mean, my God, this new show, this Ray Donovan show, it's basically the dirty side of Hollywood and a fixer, and you do the dirty work.
I do the dirty work for Ray Donovan. Yeah. I'm sort of his partner. I play Avi.
But being in Hollywood as long as you have, I'm sure a lot of this is true.
It's all true. It's all true.
But you kill people. That's true, too.
Well, I contain them. Prevention and containment, there's a difference. Sometimes you can't prevent.
Do you feel like you're getting a second wave here in your career?
Yes, I am. Yeah, I am. I'm very blessed. I'm getting a sort of a second, a rebirth, sort of. Because you make your choices when you're young, and you have to live by them, and you live by the consequences. And you can't really force the hand of destiny. You sort of go along with it. But then as you grow up, you can learn from your mistakes and not make the same ones. I'm very fortunate, though. I mean, this is, what's falling in my lap is great, but I've been working for it. The Breaking Bad thing certainly has helped.
Yeah.
The producer is a trip. He's funny. Vince Gilligan is fantastic, the creator of the show. And he saw me, he had an idea. He's like, oh, I'm going to put Manny in the show, because he loves Scarface. So that's how those things come around.
Does the Manny from Scarface thing happen every day in your life?
Every single day is the Scarface day.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Is it always okay?
It's always okay. It's always okay. I would say 99% of the time.
The one time you don't want to be called Manny?
Well, sometimes there are guys, It's never women, Women are respectful.
Even though you said some terrible stuff in that film about women.
Yeah, but they don't hold me to it. I'm not. What happens is that some men are just—they're just children, and they're brutes, and they just have no understanding of like how to be social, or how to be civil. So they'll walk right up and go, like grab me,
Yeah. Hip hop has taken the Scarface thing to another level.
They sure did.
They've owned it.
Yeah.
What do you make of that? And
well, I'm very grateful, actually. I see it as just. That's just providence. That's just the way it happened. when the movie was released, we got killed by the critics. Yeah. When the critics really represent a sort of mainstream, you know? And it was, but it was mean. It was really mean. It was also coming from a place of political correctness. Yeah. And that's always sort of misguided anyway, you know? And Al, I remember at the time when the movie came out, you know, he prepared me because he said, I said, because we knew it was great. We knew the movie was great. And then we were also told by our peers who were seeing it, you know, the first few screenings, you know, people were like, wow, this is out there and it's beyond, you know, it's the first of its kind and there's going to be a lot of imitations. And then the next day, the reviews came out. Yeah. And it was so, it was such a stark contrast. And Al told me, he said, I told you not to read the reviews. I told you not to read the reviews. Cannot think. Don't make a lot of it, you know. Yeah, he told me, and I was just like, oh, what do I, like, they're talking about us, yeah. You know, and they were so mean, too.
When did you know, though, it was going to become a classic?
When people start, well, there were people who, like musicians, the rap music, rappers and stuff, and they would start, like, they start seizing on, like, the whole point of the film and the whole glamour or the glamorous aspect of the rise and fall. Get rich, die quick, or get rich quick, die fat, I don't know, die young.
You get money and then you're dying.
Yeah. Get money and then you die. First you get the power. And what happened is that once I saw that they were, it was like, wow, there's a whole subculture that is becoming so popular because they became popular. That music became popular. And so they brought Scarface along with it.
Right.
And when MTV started showing people's homes, or cribs, and they'd say, now I gotta take you into my favorite room of the house, which is the Scarface room. And I'd be like, wow, you got a Scarface poster, you know? And also on ESPN, yep, the sports, right? Chris Berman was one of the first announcers who would, like, a home run would go, and he'd say hello to my little friend. I'd be watching, I'd be like, what, that's some Scarface? Yeah. You know, and started going mainstream. But that was 10 years after the release. That was right. Like 92, 93, 94, 95. Right. Then it started picking up.
What a real pleasure. Thanks for coming in, man.
Thanks, man.
Steven Bowers, buddy. Ray Donovan is the show. It airs on the Movie Network. We'll be right back.